Good morning, my dear students. I think you all are happy since we are locked up in our tiny room or in our home. Please don't lose your home. Continue your studies. It is a reality. Anyway, we have to overcome this effect of this small, tiny virus corona. At that time onwards, we will win over corona. So let us take forward. But this is not my topic today. I am going to take the electricity chapter that is related to the electrics. The last class, I told you that the electricity passing through a conductor. Conductor is always offers their resistance. That means free flow of current is normal. That is the meaning of the resistance. Today we are going to do one experiment. That experiment is given in your textbook. So here we can see a red diagram here. And it is red diagram. I am taking four type of conductors here. I am using the first conductor, that is a nichrome wire, and this nichrome wire having a length L meter, for example. So I am writing here L nichrome wire. First one, and this nichrome wire is connected to the circuit and both the circuit, you know that current is passing through this circuit and enter into the nichrome wire. Through the nichrome wire it is going and coming to the ammeter. Here you can see the ammeter. Ammeter also passing through ammeter, that is the circuit, that is the ammeter. And here what we have to do is note down the reading of ammeter while the current is passing through nichrome wire L. Note down the reading of this ammeter. This is the first step of this experiment. And what this you know that the ammeter is used to measure the magnitude of. So, you note down the magnitude of current and it will give in ampere. So, you can note down how many ampere of current is taken by this nichrome. Then second one, second experiment or second conductor, the same nichrome wire, but length is increase, double. So nichrome wire, I am changing the nichrome wire here and a double length nichrome wire is taken. Double length. It is almost double length. The double length, that is 2L. And using this nichrome wire, now it is a 2L, length is double. And circuit is answered is, and you note down the ammeter reading. So while this time, while you are note down the ammeter reading decreases half of the reading, somehow half of the reading, that is one by two reading reduced. So shown by this ammeter. Suppose if the current is flowing through the first experiment, if it is 3 ampere, now it will become 1.5 ampere. What does it mean? Current flowing through the resistor, that is decreasing. when the length is increased double. So we can write, why is the strength of current is reduced? Because the resistance increased. So we can write, resistance is directly proportional to length of the current. R is directly proportional to length. That is, resistance increases, the flow of current reduces to half. This is the second experiment that we are going to research. And the third case, we are removing the conductor again. This conductor is removed. And the thickness of the nickel wire increases. Double thickness. Nickel wire increases. Same length only, not to a double length, same length of nickel wire, but the thickness is twice. And we say that the area of cross section is more. So you know area of cross section, and area of cross section is more, the third is. Length is same, but area of cross section increases. And again the reading is known down from the ammeter. And in this third experiment we have seen that the ammeter reading changes. And it changes like this. That means when the area of cross section increases, resistance become lower or decreases. Resistance become decreases. That means we can write resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross section. This is a third aspect. Resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross section. That is a A. A stands for area of cross section. Now that is a third case. And fourth case, we change the nickel pipe and same length, same area of cross section, we are substituting a copper wire. Now the nickel wire changes and copper wire is given to the connection. What will be the observation? So when the copper wire is substituted by nickel wire, again it tells that ammeter reading changes. That is what do you infer or what do you understand from this? Why the ammeter reading changes? So here see that the ammeter reading changed because the material of the conductor changed. First three experiments I am using nickel wire. And fourth time using this copper wire. So from this we are going to make an equation. Now the second experiment that we know that resistance is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. And the third experiment we see that resistance is inversely proportional to the area of cross section of the current. Now the first equation and the second equation combine. And while you are combining this equation, you will get R is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to K. Third equation. And that is also equal to R is equal to rho but it is not P, it is rho. So rho L by A. This is the resistance of a conductor. The resistivity of the conductor, that can be measured by using this equation. R is equal to rho, the Greek letter rho, by L by E. So this is the experiment we have done. This is a nicely explained the test today itself. You go through the diagram and try to understand what is the instrument, what are the factors that determines the resistance of the conductor. So I'm saying the resistance of the conductor depends upon the length of the conductor, the area of the cross section of the conductor, and the material of the conductor. These are the three factors depending the resistance of a conductor. So resistance, again I repeat, resistance is a quality of the resistor to oppose the free flow of current through it. And this law or this one you have the number, but on the factors of resistance depends that we have to see.